Hey, good evening, everybody. Greetings, greetings, greetings in the wonderful name of Jesus. The Lord is good, and he is greatly to be praised. He's greatly to be magnified and adored. Won't you do me a favor tonight, saints of God? Won't you please just put in the comment section if the sound is clear, and so we can get into doing what God has called us to do. A special greetings this evening to who's there. Just let us know where you're watching us from. Q and I see you. Leanne, Elric, I see you. Louisa, Sergio, Grace and Peace. Merle, good evening to you. Leanne, wonderful to have you. Family, wonderful to have you. Auntie Merle, I think you're all the way in Cape Town, if my memory serves me correct. Greetings, Pastor Kista, from Grace, from Gangs to Grace. Wonderful to have you.
Hallelujah.
Please mute your mic if you're on the media team. Your sound is coming through. Hallelujah. Glory to his holy name. Glory to his holy name. Hallelujah. 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 Muscle by. Greetings, woman of God. I'm excited to have you tonight. I'm excited to be with the saint of God. Come on, let us know where you're watching us from. My mom's here. Glory be to the holy name of Jesus. Oh, we're going to have a good time in the presence of the Lord. The devil tried to steal our joy tonight. But we're going to continue and we're going to have a good time in the presence of the Lord. Somebody shout amen. Somebody shout hallelujah. Glory be to his holy name. Coach Lady May is also in the building, on the online building. Great to see you, woman of God. Greetings to you, greetings to you, greetings to you, greetings to you. Jocelyn, I see you. I see you, Tyrese. I see you, I see you. Evangelist Daryl, I see you. Come on, come on. Put in the comment section. Get someone online tonight. Put somebody's name in the comment section. We're going to do this thing tonight. We're going to be in the presence of the Lord tonight. And I'm excited. I'm excited. Kayla, Psalmist Kayla, it's good to see you. Auntie Julie, it's wonderful to have you. Woman of God, Uncle Brian, if you are watching somewhere in the house, grace and peace to you. Hallelujah. Come on, let's get more people online. Let's get more people online. Let's get more people online. Auntie Cynthia, it's good to have you. It's wonderful to have you. Those numbers are climbing. We're getting to 35. Essie David, wonderful to have you. Invited Sister Leanne, wonderful. Wonderful. Grace and peace to you, woman of God. Let us know where you're watching from. Are you also in Muscle Bay or Cape Town? We're going to have a good time in the presence of the Lord tonight, Sister Debbie. Q&A, good to have you. Hallelujah. Riba shondala hande kitalaba suku tulubusia. Sister Janice, it's wonderful to have you tonight, woman of God. You are one of our 6 a.m. devotion family, and we're happy that you've come to connect. Lucinda, we see you, woman of God. Louis, we see you coming in. Habashanda basianda. Hindalahandorodobo sikanda basia. Let me get this name correctly. Let me just go back here. Essie Davis, I think you, Leanne's mom. Greetings to you, woman of God. You've birthed a significant gift to the kingdom of God, and we're grateful. We want to honor you tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you for raising up and training up your child in the way that she should go. Kay, Ray, it's wonderful to have you. Woo! Jesus. Okay, I think we still climbing. The numbers are still climbing. I'm gonna get started tonight. And if you have been following me, Lerato, wonderful to have you. If you've been following on the 6 a.m., I've said to the family this evening, I'm gonna invite a significant, powerful gift to Circle Church. In the person of Pastor Gerd Jackson. He's the lead pastor of Anchor Church out in Upington, doing a significant work He's authored two books, and he is the good friend of my spiritual father, Pastor Brandon Bailey, who I'd like to honor tonight. And as we were in talks for Pastor Ger to come on to tonight's feed, if you follow on the 6 a.m. devotion, I said to my wife, it is not business as usual. And so I don't feel like continuing in the series, Thou is an Overcomer. Although it's a great series, it's a wonderful series, but I strongly believe that because of where we are and what's happening concerning the riots and so forth, I just felt led by the Holy Ghost that we have to do something different. It cannot be business as usual. And so whilst in prayer, my wife and I were busy making some food, and we were trusting God for a name. We were trusting God for a word. And in just spending time, how many of us know that you can pray while making food? You can pray while being doing stuff. Tamlin Berger, it's good to see you all the way from Mosul. By God bless you. And so whilst we were speaking, we were not sure who we're going to invite. And we normally do this according to the Spirit of the Lord. Heba Shanda. And so as the thought left us and God hadn't spoken in that time, we were in the room and I was on my phone going through Facebook, and I joined my friend. And there Pastor Ger Jackson was releasing a word. Woo! He was releasing a word of impartation, and God, whilst he was ministering, God said to me, that's the word. It came through clearly, that's the word for the season. And I wondered how I'm going to get this done because it was late already, past 8. And this is my father's friend, and I'm just going to just get into his inbox and invite him without a letter, without protocol. But anyway, I followed the voice of God, and I boxed the man, and I thankfully I had his cell phone number. I sent him a WhatsApp, and I said, God said to me that you've got to deliver the same word of tonight for Circle Church, because we believe that God wants to do something different. It's not business as usual. And he agreed excitedly. He said, yes, he will come and he will share the word. My goodness, I almost jumped through the roof of excitement. And we prepared, and he sent me a few scriptures which he was going to preach tonight and so forth and so forth. And this morning at about 9 o'clock, he texted me and he said, Pastor, I'm not feeling well. Pastor, I don't know what's happening, but I can hardly speak. My nose is blocked, and he was showing symptoms of flu and so forth. And he said to me, he's going to take a nap during the day. He's going to doctor himself, and we will talk again midday or close to the time we're going to go live. And I specifically never bothered him because I was in prayer, trusting God that if this is what God is saying, that the word will come through forth and there won't be any hindrances. And at about 6:30, he sent me a message saying, we assessed the situation, and that did not look good. In fact, his health took a turn, and he said that he would be better off if he waits this one out and he meets with us at another time. Because his strength is low and he wants to do justice to the request that God had asked through me. And so this evening, family, I want to let you know that Pastor Ger Jackson is not going to join us tonight. He will be joining us at another junction. We'll try maybe tomorrow or definitely next week. And I was as disappointed as you, the family, would be tonight. But nevertheless, we're here and we're going to spend time in the presence of the Lord. Again, I want to say to somebody tonight, we are not going to preach from our normal word. I'm not going to preach the word tonight. And I'm not going to preach the word in the series. And when Pastor Jackson, during the day, I was pondering on what word we could minister, or how I could lead a prayer session tonight, God dropped something into my spirit Somebody say amen. And so there are no scriptures. I haven't given the media team anything. You're going to have to work with me. And so before we get into prayer, I just want us to commit as a community. Just pray for Pastor Gert. Let's just pray for a minute or so and just direct our prayer and our attention to Upington. Father, in the name of Jesus, we speak a word of healing. We realize tonight that the devil is trying to rob us from a word. We realize tonight the attack, the immediate attack on Pastor Gert's health and his life based on his obedience to release a word that I believe is a word we need for this hour and for this season. And so, Lord, we send your word of healing right now to Upington. Touch him afresh from the crowns of his head to the soles of his feet. Make him whole. Healing virtues, touch him right now. In Jesus' mighty name, we send the word of healing. And so whilst we are going to pray tonight, I just want to get into a quick word, and then we're going to spend time praying. If you have a prayer request, if you have joined specifically to hear Pastor Gert, he's not going to join us tonight, but we are here and we will get Pastor Gert Jackson to join us, if not tomorrow, early next week, because I believe the word that he is carrying is indeed for the season. Pastor Wesley, Pastor Kester, thank you. Evangelist Justin, thank you for agreeing and standing with me. And so if you've got a Bible, get your Bible. Media team, you're just going to have to work with me. John chapter number 5. John chapter number 5. I'm going to read the entire story here. I'm going to expose do an expository of the text. And then we are going to pray. It's good to see you this evening. Grace and peace to you. Hallelujah. Glory be to his holy name. And so with the time that is afforded us, I want to get straight into the word. Thank you. John chapter number 5 from verses 1. The Bible says sometime later, God, Jesus was just healing somebody else. And so we pick up now, sometime later, Jesus went to Jerusalem for one of the Jewish festivals. Remember, everything happened in Jerusalem. Jerusalem was the headquarters. Listen to this. Verse 2 says, Now there in Jerusalem, near the sheep gate, a pool, which in Aramaic was also called Bethesda. Somebody put in the comment section, Bethesda. The Bible says there was a pool named Bethesda, which is surrounded by five covered colonnades, or also known as porches, or also known as places. There were five different places or porches or stoops, as we would call it. And here is a great number of disabled people. Listen to this. There was a great number of disabled people that used to lay there. There was a great number of perplexed people. There was a great number of people that were suffering in the riot. Hey, there was a great number of people who were filled with anxiety because of what we are experiencing, Kayla. There was a great number of people that were in fear and perplexed and were needing a word. Watch this. And the Bible says, the blind, the lame, and the paralyzed. They were fearful. They were filled with anxiety. They needed healing, Pastor Wesley. There were just many problems. They were just sitting at the pool. And the Bible says, verse 5, one was there who had been invalid. Hey, oh my God, I've come to speak to somebody here tonight that before you were even in the situation, before you even got to the pool, they already gave you a name. They called you the whore. Before you got to the pool gate, they called you the thief. They called you the drug addict. They called you the homosexual. They called you some sort of name which gave you a feeling of being invalid. Somebody put in the comment section, invalid. And the Bible says, this invalid person was there for about 38 years. Yeah, Bashanda. He was there for 38 years. How many of us know that we can sit with our problem for years? Surely we can sit with our problem year in and year out. Year in and year out. Imelda, welcome. Watch verse 6. The Bible says, when Jesus saw him laying there, and learned that he had been in this condition for a long time. I want you to hear something clearly. It was not that Jesus was caught by surprise. Woo, Jesus. Jesus learned. Oh, I'm gonna preach this thing. He learned that the man was sitting there in that condition for many years, and Jesus could not understand because the solution was right there. Oh my God, I'm gonna preach. And so how many of us know that many of us are sitting in our problems, are sitting in our perplexities, and the solution is right there. I've come to declare to somebody here tonight that Jesus Christ is the solution. Listen to this. The Bible says, and Jesus, he was sitting there in his condition for a long time. And so Jesus asked him, do you want to get well? Put that in the comment section. Do you want to get well tonight? I don't know who I'm speaking to, but I heard the Spirit of the Lord ask me to ask the people of God, do you want to get well tonight? I've come to declare to somebody here tonight that healing is at your doorstep. Tonight is your night of healing. Tonight is your night of deliverance. Tonight is the night that you're turning your life around. I said, tonight is your night. And the Bible says Jesus asks the man, he asks the invalid, he asks the invalid person, he says, do you want to be well? Come on, put in the comment section, I want to be well. I want to be well. Melissa from Leidenberg, God bless you. And the Bible says, this is what the verse 7, the Bible says, sir, the invalid replied. Woo! How many of us become so used to the label that they put on us? How many of us become used to the thing that they call you useless? How many of us become used to the label that they put on us? You even answer from the viewpoint of your infirmity. Oh, the diabetic. Oh, Jesus. The addicted one. The liar. I don't know what name. And so he replies from the place of his weakness. And the Bible says, I have no one. Listen to what he says. He says, I have no one, to help me into the pool when the water is stirred. Come on, somebody. I've got news for somebody here tonight. There is a stirring. Put it in the comment section. There is a stirring here tonight. There is a stirring that is happening. There is a stirring, child of God. And this man, the invalid, asks, he says to Jesus, well, nobody is here to help me. I've got no one to help me. I've got no one to carry me to the pool. Oh, Jesus. Watch this. And the Bible says, whilst I listen to his excuse, he says, while I am trying to get in, somebody else goes ahead of me. Somebody else goes ahead of me. Hey, I'm going to come in a moment. The Bible says, and verse 8 says, then Jesus said to him, get up. Get up, pick up your mat and walk. Come on, put in the comment section tonight. You better get up. Put in the comment section, take your mat and walk. Put in the comment section, get up. And the Bible says, at once the man got cured. Somebody say, suddenly. God is about to turn somebody's life around. Suddenly, God is about to turn things in your favor. God is about to turn things in your favor, Uncle Brian. The Bible says, he got up, Hebashanda. He picked up his mat and he walked. The day on which he took place was on a Sabbath. I've come to declare to somebody here tonight, I'm going to get into this thing a little bit deeper, but God is going to do something in an extraordinary way. God is going to use the situation of the pandemic. God is going to use the rioting situation to bring a blessing to you. Oh, Jesus, I'm here to tell somebody tonight, that even though people are losing their jobs, God is going to open up a business in your name. I've come to declare to somebody here tonight, Sharon, that even though it doesn't look like it, even though it seems like companies are retrenching, and they are, but we are not governed by the authority. We are not governed by this world. Listen to this. The Bible says, and he did it on the Sabbath. The law forbids you to carry your mat. Listen to verse 11. But he replied, the man who made me well said to me, I must do it. Child of God, there is something about obedience in the season. There is something about obedience that is going to take you through. There is something about your obedience. And so the word that Pastor Gert was going to bring tonight was to do with obedience. Oh, Jesus, I feel this word again. I can't wait for him to come. But there is going to be, God is going to require something from us in the season that's going to carry us through. Oh, my God. Pick up your mat. Pick up your mat and walk. Oh, listen to verse 12. The Bible says, so they asked him, who is the fella? Who is the fellow that told you to pick up your mat and walk? I've come to declare to you that God is going to do something great that people will not be able to understand. They're going to ask you, but how did you change from being this or from being that to this? How did you get here? You had no money. How did you formulate the business and now you are hiring people? You could not even get a job in 2020. And you're going to answer them. Listen to this. In verse 13, he says, the man who healed me, he had no idea, for Jesus had slipped away into the crowd. I've come to declare to you that in this season, God is going to do an uncommon thing, and then he's going to move. He's going to do an uncommon thing. So look at verse 14, and then we're going to talk and pray. The Bible says, later, Jesus found him at the table and said, see, you are well again. Stop sinning, or something worse may happen to you. Listen to this. The Bible says in verse 15, the man went away and he told the Jewish elders that it was Jesus who made me well. It was who? It was Jesus who made me well. Hebashanda, did you hear what God Jesus says to him in the latter part of that story? He says, I'm glad to see you are well. He says, go and sin no more. In the season, we are going to need obedience and we are going to need repentance. Oh my goodness. This morning in our devotion, Acts chapter 3:19, we spoke about the fact that Jesus says, repent, Hebashanda. Not only because it will cleanse you from your sins, but it will bring a refreshing. Woo! I've come to declare to somebody here this evening that it is the repentance. It is our constant repentance that's going to bring refreshing. Somebody say, we need refreshing. Listen to this. And so, child of God, we are now in a season. Woo, Jesus. We are in a season. Let me just deal with this quickly. We are in a season. Oh, my goodness. We are in a season where we are going to deal. Hey, we are in a season where we're going to look at the natural, but we are going to see things through the unnatural. Watch me. You may be in a situation where you are trying to ascertain what Christ is doing. You may look at your business that burnt. You may look at the situation and say, I'll never recover from this. But I've come to declare to somebody here tonight that God is about to do something uncommon. Somebody shout uncommon. God is about to do something uncommon. Watch this. And so although we are in the natural, Kayla, we are going to experience supernatural. Somebody put in the comment section, supernatural. Listen to this. In John chapter 4, the Bible says that Jesus is looking for those that worship him in spirit and in truth. Why? Because it's in the spirit that God can give you instruction. And the instruction is going to be uncommon. Ooh, the instruction is going to make you look mad. The instruction is going to make you look like you are cuckoos, but I've come to declare to you, it is in the obedience. Woo! It is in the obedience. Watch me. When last have you woken up? I feel like standing. When last have you woken up and just said, thank you, God, for my salvation? Oh, the situation, this rioting, this pandemic, this fear, this anxiety is making us no longer wake up and just be grateful. When last have you just said, God, I want to thank you for my salvation. I thank you for my mercy. I thank you for my grace. I thank you for the blood. And so what's happening now, we are retreating like the man who was sick at the pool. We're laying there with many excuses. It's a pandemic. We're laying there. Oh my God, there's rioting. And God is saying, do you walk by faith or do you walk by sight? And so tonight, I'm here to encourage somebody. I'm here to lift up somebody's faith. I'm here to declare to you, stop laying there. If you've noticed, child of God, Pastor Ashwin, welcome. If you've noticed, whenever God moves, he generally moves in places of obscurity. He generally moves in famine, as Joseph. He generally moves when there's war, speak to David. And so God does supernatural things. Ooh! When we least expect it, somebody shout, amen. There is a stirring taking place. And so we've got to wake up and be grateful. When last have we just had a revival service, a testimony service, where we just speak of the goodness of the Lord, where we come like the mothers of old and declare, ek het 'n dankbare hart vanaand vir wat die Here gedoen het in my kind se lewe. Ek het 'n dankbare hart vanaand vir wat die Here gedoen het. My huis was nie gevat aan Debosaka. And so the season is making you live. This is why John, 1 John says, you are not of this world, even though you live in it. Woo! Hey, watch this. And so tonight, I want to ask a question. Put it in the comment section. Do you believe again? Do you still believe tonight? Oh, it's so good to see you, Mother Lorena. So many of the saints of God have fallen asleep. We no longer believe because of what we see, but we forget. We know a God who specializes in uncommon things. We know a God who moves in obscurity. We know a God who gives us bread in famine. We know a God who's able to give someone the stone to slay Goliath. Heba Sandam, do you believe? Do you believe tonight, child of God? Hey, and so we've got to put our hope and our trust in God. Listen to this. The problem is we've been putting our trust and our hope in man, your boss. You've been putting your hope and your trust in your company. And so now you're not sure what's going to happen because the boss is talking about short time. The boss is saying that maybe we'll not recover. Yeah, I've come to declare to somebody here tonight, my God owns a cattle upon 1,000 hills. He's the one who's given you the ability to create wealth. And so I've come to tell you, better jump in the pool tonight because Jesus is here and he wants to do something in your life. Hey, what did I write down here? Oh, watch me, child of God. I've come to declare to you, the Bible says when you listen to the opening, it says they were laying there paralyzed. They were laying there sick. They were laying there, I don't know what else. You fill the blanks of your life. I've come to say to somebody here tonight, my God, hey, Mashande Bosa, Yahweh, he specializes in sick. He specializes in broken. He specializes in impossibilities. Do you believe tonight, child of God? Hey, Basanda, I have come to declare to somebody here tonight that you are the solution. You always hear me saying every problem has a solution, and God is calling you. God wants to raise you up, but you're sitting at the pool. And the Bible says Jesus asked, he was concerned, he could not understand, why are you just sitting there? I've come to tell somebody tonight, you better jump up. You better jump into the bath and into the pool tonight. Listen to this. The Bible says in Acts chapter number 10, Jesus is always doing good. Somebody put in the comment section, he's always doing good. Hey, watch me. This is a season where we're going to see uncommon things. And so whilst we are looking at uncommon things, there are three things. Or did I put here two? Maybe three. Number one, you've got to stop looking at your budget, because your budget is not going to get you through. Whoop. You've got to stop looking at your salary, because God doesn't specialize in things that make sense. Oh, Jesus, I just said something. God is calling you to something greater than what your credit card can buy. Woo! Number two, you've got to get rid of the current context. There are some people you've got to get rid of tonight. There are some people you've got to get rid of tonight. I've come to declare to you that the idea you have is not good enough, because it's your idea. I've come to declare to you tonight, you've got to sit and prevail in the presence of God, just like Joseph, who was in the pit and crying and saying, God, did you forget me? But God was busy orchestrating. Somebody put in the comment section, the Here is Biesach on my side, verka. He's busy orchestrating it in the midst of famine, in the midst of a riot, in the midst of the pandemic. God is working out my case. Vishan Michael says in his song, it won't always be like this. The Lord will perfect that concern in me. Listen to me. There is a miracle where you serve a miracle working God tonight. Listen to me, child of God. I don't know what sickness you're sitting with. I don't know what label is put on you. I don't know what they say about your skin color, about your dress code, about the culture you come from, about the fact that you are black, previously disadvantaged. I've come to declare to you, when God says you can do something, there's no demon, there's no witch, there's no warlock that can keep you from it tonight. Shout, I serve a miracle working God. And so the Bible says, there is a pool. Somebody put in the comment section, there is a pool with my name on it. There is a pool that is waiting for me. Yay. There is a pool tonight. There is a pool tonight. Somebody shout, I can smell the water. And so tonight, child of God, I want to say this as I draw to a close. You, child of God, cannot go to the water unless you are thirsty. You cannot go to the water unless you be thirsty. And so God has to do something sometimes to create a thirst. Sande Bosaka. He has to do something to create a hunger within you. This is why Matthew 5 says, those that hunger, those that thirst will be filled. The problem is we've become so relaxed at the pool. It's 38 years and you're still sitting. You're still in your crying in your situation. Watch this. And so you could be at the right place, Hebashanda, at the wrong time. Woo! I just said something there. You could be at the right place at the wrong time. You've got to get in when there is a stirring. You've got to get in when Jesus is in the altar. You've got to listen to the strategy. You've got to know when God, when you to launch. You've got to know when to register the business. You've got to know what to do. You could be at the wrong, right place at the wrong time. Or you could be at the wrong place at the right time. Watch me. The Bible declares tonight that there is a Kairos moment. I believe that in the season, Pastor Ashwin, we are in a Kairos. Woo! We are in a moment that won't be repeated. And I want to declare to somebody here tonight, don't miss it. Don't allow what's taking place, woo, to push you off balance, to give you middle ear infection. Don't allow the riots and the pandemic to take you off focus. You are on an assignment. I've come to tell you tonight, you are on an assignment. I've come to declare to somebody here tonight, it's your turn. It's your time. It's your turn. It's your time. I said it's your turn and it's your time. What else did I write down? In the few moments I had to put something, the Bible says, and he emerged. Woo! Listen to this. There were so many people laying there, but only a few were healed. Oh, Jesus, I said something. There were so many people, but only a few were healed. Why? Because oftentimes, child of God, oftentimes God is doing something, but you are watching the person in front of you. Ay, Yara. You've allowed them to do this. I glue. And so what's happening is you lose focus. Oh, based on what you see. And so the Bible says, he said to Jesus, every time I want to go, somebody goes ahead of me. Don't allow somebody, my peeps. Don't allow somebody's blessing to make you eat your seed. Don't allow somebody's harvest to make you eat your seed. Oh, Jesus. I just said something there. And so, child of God, listen to this. You got to get out of that group. Too long have you been enabling each other. Too long is that group an enablement group. All y'all do is complain about how much month there is and how little money. All y'all do is complain about how sick you are and how dependent you are on the medication. God is saying to you, there's a stirring happening. Get out of that company. Woo, Jesus. Listen to this and I'm done. You have been enabled by your friends, maybe enabled by your family. Listen to this. They were sitting there, just sitting and waiting. And every time they want to move, they say, oh, but so-and-so went ahead of me. Just because I got my house before you doesn't mean you must stop applying. Just because your business is successful doesn't mean I'm not going to be a great businessman. Just because I've been struggling for 5 years doesn't mean I'm not called to millions. So I'm preaching to somebody here tonight. Don't allow the harvest somebody's eating to make you eat your seed. You've got seed in the ground. And so the word Bethesda, I want to give you this and then I'm done. The word Bethesda, Pastor Kester will tell you, because he's theologically inclined, he will tell you that the word Bethesda also means cycle. Woo! Jesus. And so I've come to declare to you tonight that God works in cycles. I said to the devotional church this morning that nothing is new. The Bible says everything that was already is, and everything that is already was. What does that mean? Where we are at is not new for God. It may be new for you and I, but God has been here before. God knows exactly what to do. And this is why he creates a Kairos moment. This is why he creates a Kairos moment in the midst of our pandemic. Woo! Because Bethesda is a cycle. It comes and it goes. Somebody say, I'm waiting for my moment. I've come to declare to somebody here tonight, your moment is tonight. Your moment is tonight. Woo! Bethesda. All waiting for something. Listen to me. Many of us on this group tonight, on this chat broadcast, you might listen to this later. We are all waiting for our Bethesdas, but we're having different experiences. You see, I may be addicted. You may have an illness. Somebody else may be. I don't know, but we are all waiting for our Kairos moments. We're all waiting for God to do something in different capacities, in different struggles, in different frustrations. The problem is we try to quantify who should be going first based on who is worse sick. Oh, Jesus, I just said something. Who needs God more? God doesn't work like that. God, the Bible says he will show favor to whomever he chooses to show favor to. I don't know why I said that. Let me just close with this. There is different difficulties. There are some waiting for healing and some waiting for miracles. Some waiting for success and others waiting for something. Here's the question you must ask yourself. You must ask yourself tonight. Why is it? The Bible says there were many at the pool, but only one or two get healed. Oh, Jesus. Why is it that not all of them were healed? Why is it that not all of them took the opportunity? You want to know why, child of God? I'm glad you asked. Because when we start to quantify things based on our logic, based on our reason, based on our cerebral context, we lose what God is doing in the moment. Oh, Jesus. But God, so-and-so doesn't have a qualification. How can you bless her with such a vehicle? How can she work at an organization like like that. So and so never went to beauty school, but she has the handsomest husband in town. So and so. And so what happens is you start to discredit yourself based on what God is doing in somebody else's life. And so in the Kairos moment, you start to think that it's not for you. You start to believe it's not for you. But I've come to tell you tonight, there is place for one more. Somebody put in the comment section, one more. There is place for one more. One more. Oh, my God. And so tonight, child of God, watch this. I'm done. The Bible says he made an excuse. He said, when Christ asked him, do you want to be healed? In other words, Christ came to his level. He says, have you not heard? I have healed so-and-so. Have you not seen me turn so-and-so's life around? Have you not seen me provide for so-and-so when they don't have a degree? Have you not seen me taking that person who studied for so long and made him something great and wonderful to the place where he... Have you not seen what I've done? The Bible says he was sitting there and he said to Jesus, I have no one to help me. Listen to me, child of God, I'm done. I want to close here prophetically. The Bible says, ask and it shall be what? You know the scripture given to you. Where's my Bible readers? It says, knock and the door shall be open. Here's the problem. Woo, let me take a step back. Sometimes we read the word of God, but we don't read it correctly. Woo, Jesus. And so could it be that he was laying there, but he was asking the wrong question? Burton, it's good to see you, man of God. Could it be that he was sitting there, but asking the wrong question? Kewan, the Bible says, ask and it shall be given. But when you ask amiss, oh Jesus, I just said something. When you ask amiss, you got to wait for another moment of Kairos. Child of God, the Bible says, knock and the door will be open. But if you're knocking on the wrong door, there's probably nobody home. Woo! If you're knocking at the wrong organization, there's probably no one to let you in. I want to close with this. And so in this season, we've got to ask the right question. Woo! John is in prison. He sends his disciples to Jesus. He says, go ask Jesus, is he the one or shall I look for another? You are sitting in this mess, asking yourself, how can I still do business? Businesses are closing. How can I still register a company? My goodness, it's going to take 5 years, 2 years, 1 year, I don't know, to get the economy going. You are sitting and saying to yourself, ooh, but so-and-so was healthy, but yet they died. I don't think, ooh, Jesus. And so you're making so many excuses and you're missing the Kairos moment of God. And so tonight, child of God, the reason why Jesus doesn't answer John's question directly, because he asked the wrong question. Tonight, as we draw to a close, I don't know what you're asking, but you better reevaluate what you're asking the master as he's passing by. Don't ask stupid questions. Don't ask things that make no sense. Of course, God wants you healed. The Bible says healing is the children's bread. Of course, God wants you rich. The Bible says he will give you the desires of your heart. Of course, God wants all those things. But you're asking amiss. You're knocking at the wrong door. You're going to Mrs. Jones. You're going to the Ewing family. You're going to the Foresters. You're depending on the Kardashians, and God saying, that's the wrong door. I'm sending you to somebody in obscurity. I'm sending you to somebody that you wouldn't even think. And so you're writing off the plan of God because it doesn't make logical sense. I've come to declare to you tonight, as I draw, as I close, that in the season, we are getting ready for what we know as the uncommon. Somebody put in the comment section, at least 50 of you, the uncommon of God. And so even in the season of loss, I've come to declare to you tonight, God is about to add. Even in the season of great retrenchment, God is about to promote. I've come to declare to you in the season of retrenchment, of repossession and dismissal, God is about to give you that thing that you've been deserved. It is an uncommon thing in an uncommon season, but it's going to require your obedience. Somebody shout obedience. Somebody shout obedience. I'm done. And so tonight, child of God, how obedient are you in the season? How repentful are you in the season? I want to close with this. God is going to make a demand on the children of God. God is going to make a demand on the remnant, Milton. God is going to make a significant demand on us. He's asking, do you want to be healed? Because healing is the first part of where God is taking us. Healing is supposed to be obvious. That's why Jesus says he was astonished that the man was still sitting there, but he gave him the solution. He was astonished that in the season, you're not connected to a church. He's astonished in the season, you're not giving the way you're supposed to be giving. He's astonished that you're letting go of the principles because you're looking at what's popular. Here, Bashanda, I've come to declare to you tonight, child of God, it's going to need an uncommon thing of obedience. You see, Joseph had to do something that was uncommon. David did something that was I can give you many lists. Tonight, are you prepared to do the uncommon in an uncommon season? Because God wants to use you. Let me say this to you tonight. You want to know why you're in that WhatsApp group of those, everyone who enables each other, or that divorce group, or that drinking group, or that addicted, I don't know. Because God is waiting for you to jump in, hey Bashanda, so that you can be the effect and the change for everybody in that WhatsApp group. Because they are all sitting there laying at the gate, laying at the pool. But God wants to get you in so that he can use you to touch their lives. Listen to me. It's a season of uncommon. God wants to do uncommon things in an uncommon way to bring unprecedented results. I don't know who this word is for here tonight, but my Bible teaches me, the word of God teaches me concerning obedience tonight, child of God. It is better than sacrifice. The word of God is so clear tonight, child of God. Woo! I don't want to mess up too much, but we've got to be obedient. It's not going to make sense. You're going to look crazy. How can you send a CV to a company that's folding? Don't listen to popularity. Don't listen to, what's her name? Zakina and the lady on Morning Live. Don't listen. Listen to the voice of God. Listen to the voice of God in this season. God is going to require an uncommon thing, child of God, which is going to give you an uncommon result. Oftentimes when there is famine, it's known as a time of storing. It's known as a time of strategy. It's known as a time of working. Saint of God, children of God, hear me clearly. We got to get working. We've got seed in the ground. God is going to bring strategy to some of us that is going to blow the minds of economists. It's going to blow the minds of your bosses. Listen to the voice of God. Don't listen to popularity. Don't listen to the neighbor complaining. Yes, we know the situation is bad. We know things look crazy, but we've got to trust God. We've got to trust God. I can think of so many examples in Genesis where Moses didn't know and God said, what's in your hand? When God said, put the stick, it looked crazy. Where he took the stick and he turned it into, I'm telling you, we're going back to those times where we got to have the tenacity of Elijah that says, let me show you what my God can do. You take that wood and put it in water, and I'm going to call fire from heaven, and it's going to burn out. I'm coming to tell somebody here tonight, God is going to do extraordinary things using normal people in an extraordinary time. Open up your ear, child of God. Don't get confused with Sakina and Melanie and these people and what you see in the neighbor and people are crying. Yes, it's a season for that. But God is calling out the remnant. God is calling, selecting 1, 2, 3, 5. He's calling out his children because he wants to give them the next step. Somebody put in the comment section, the next step is going to require my obedience. Let's pray. Hallelujah. Father, tonight in the name of Jesus. Come and pray with me, saint of God. If you can pray in the Holy Ghost, pray in the Holy Ghost. There's no more time to be shy about who's watching you, who's in the room. Where? Come on. Lift up your voice as a trumpet tonight and pray with me. Hallelujah. Glory be to the holy name of Jesus. Rabo sa nikandele bosa katalabande le de bosa. Hindande kurande le basu kutelubu shianda. Father, I thank you in the name of Jesus. It is a difficult time, but I've seen you move, God. I've seen you move in difficult seasons, in difficult times. I've seen you do great and mighty things. I've read about your healing. I've read about your miraculous power. And so tonight, God, in the name of Jesus, I pray that you open up our ears that we may hear you in the season, God. I pray in the name of Jesus that you call the remnant. I pray tonight, Lord, that you will no longer have excuses about sitting at the pool. I pray tonight, God, that you use us to do uncommon things. Yeah. In an uncommon time. Woo, Jesus, to get uncommon results. You see, when you talk about the canker worm shall restore, or rather, when you shall restore what the canker worm has eaten, it's going to require uncommon things. Father, I preach and I declare and I decree tonight that Joseph will rise. I decree and I declare tonight there will be a Deborah in our midst. I decree and I declare tonight there will be a Samson of this time. I decree and I declare tonight that there will be a Jacob who won't let go until you bless him. I decree and I declare tonight that you will raise up a Solomon who will hold the wisdom of God for the season. I declare that you will raise up an Abraham that will birth the new generation, the new families of the earth. I declare tonight that you will raise up a David, God, that will not be afraid of the fight, who will not be afraid of the season. I pray in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that you raise up a Samson, man and woman of strength, man and woman that know how to travail. I pray that you will raise up a Nehemiah, God, that will build and rebuild the wall. I pray in the name of Jesus tonight that you raise up an Esther who knows how to hide the gift of God until the right moment. Lord God, I pray tonight, God, by the mercies of God, that we will hear you like Elijah. Father, that we will have the tenacity of Elijah that says, I don't care what you've done. I don't care how much money you have. I don't care how much this country is looted. I don't know what tomorrow holds, but I know a God who owns the cattle upon a thousand hills. Tonight, God, I pray in the name of Jesus, let God arise and let his enemies be scattered tonight. Let the children of God take their rightful place. Child of God, I just heard something in the spirit. The Bible declares that the wealth, Hebashanda, of the wicked shall be laid up for the just. I always wondered how. I always wondered when. But in a season that I see now, where everybody is kind of getting on the same playing field, God is about to shift the guard. Hey. God is about to bring in new CEOs. God is about to raise new millionaires. God is about to bring new companies into the fold. Because those of yesterday were good enough for yesterday's season. How long will we mourn for them? God is about to bring something new. Thank you, men of God. I pray for the anointing of Meshach, of Cedric and Abednego. It does not matter, devil, how hotter you make the fire, we're going to stand. Because we know even if we die in Christ. I need to go. May God bless you. May God bless you, child of God. If you want to sow a seed, you may do that now. I'm not going to encourage. You know what to do. If you want to sow a seed into what we're doing here at Circle, you can do that now. Under no obligation. But I believe God is, this is a Kairos moment. If you want to get in, you better get in now. If you want to get in using a seed, do so. If you believe that God is going to bless you according to your seed, do so. I want to release you with this word. It's 1 hour. I want to get off. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May his face shine upon you. May he be gracious to you. May you open up your ear in the season that you may hear what God is going to say to you. He's going to call for an uncommon thing in an uncommon season to bring uncommon results. It's going to need obedience. It's going to need constant repentance, because repentance is going to bring peace. Repentance is going to bring wisdom. Repentance is going to bring us to be able to hear God. I want to pray a blessing over somebody who doesn't know the Lord tonight. Maybe you're watching this and you don't know this Lord. You don't know this Jesus we're talking about. Inbox me. I want to pray with you. I want to walk with you. If you don't know the Lord, I want to tell you that the reason that things are happening in your life, the first step is Jesus. And after Jesus, we do with the other things. The Bible says, seek first the kingdom, and the other things shall be added in the name of Jesus. I'm done, child of God. This was the word that God gave us at short notice. We cannot preach the series when God is saying something different. I feel like David in Ziklag, Melissa, just when he went to war, just when we think the pandemic, we're getting it under control, guns are over, riot. Just when we think the riot is finished, it's going to be more unemployment and so forth and so forth. I've come to bring you this word. God is going to use uncommon things to bring us to a place of uncommon favor. May God bless you tonight. May God keep you tonight in the hollow of his mighty hand. Don't be afraid, Joshua. Be strong. Be courageous. This is not the season for fear. This is the season for uncommon things. The pool is being stirred. Don't wait for your neighbor to jump in. Don't wait for your pastor to jump in. You better jump in. Sprungen, sprungen. Goodbye, family. I need to go. I don't want to keep you longer than an hour. We'll bring Pastor Gert maybe next week or so. Please join me again 6 a.m. every morning for a devotion. And you can join us Sunday morning, 9 o'clock. God richly bless you, Tanti family. It was good to see you tonight. God bless you, saints. Bye-bye. Hallelujah. Keep us up. Thank you, Jesus.